as a celebration of our 25th anniversary at the Wexner Center for the Arts. Very privileged and honored to be presenting the personal collection of Leslie and Abigail Wexner, which focuses in particular on three titans of modernism, Picasso, Giacometti, and Dubuffet, but also includes examples of Degas and de Kooning and Susan Rothenberg. And the theme is not one imposed by us as curators, but in effect created by the eye of the collector. Les and Abigail have been really fiercely committed to figurative art. Well, of course, we thought for a long time about how we wanted to present the work in the galleries. We do scale models with little postage stamp images, and no matter how many times you rework those and move things from one place to another, once the works actually arrive and they're uncrated and they're leaning against the wall, there's always a lot of to-ing and fro-ing. I think it's fair to say that Picasso is considered the giant of 20th century art in so many respects. He was and remains the guy to contend with. Of course, with Picasso taking the lead over a very prolific career of some 70 years, inventing a new visual language just about every decade. Viewers will have a chance to really trace his evolution from the earliest sketch of Picasso's in the show, 1898, up to the last painting, in the Wexner collection from 1959. This particular painting is from a series that Dubuffet did called Orloop, which was a word of his own devising. It doesn't mean anything. He liked the sound of it. As you can see, he is focusing on very, very dark outlines of these different component parts, almost like puzzle pieces, and then doing the cross-hatching in essentially red and blue. While it may initially look like just an all-over abstraction, once you focus in, you begin to see faces looming out. It's incredibly vibrant and a surface that is never static. And from these paintings also emerged a whole body of sculptures and then theater designs, sets and costumes. Giacometti had a fascinating artistic career. He was in a constant personal struggle with his own talent. He was someone who worked and worked and worked and was never really satisfied. He was working this clay almost to the point where it could no longer hold. It was about to disintegrate. And that was something that characterized virtually all of his sculpture. There has always been this notion about him that he was depicting the horrors of the mid-20th century, the war, the starvation, the Holocaust, you name it, all of the ravages that befell humanity at that time. What the array of works together suggests is just how rich a variety of approaches to the human figure there is in art, starting with a sculpture like the Degas, and physically ending at the top of the ramp with one of those very tall, attenuated figures by Giacometti of a standing woman. And then everything in between, from the neoclassical to the surreal. So the idea of transfiguration, or the constant metamorphosis, the constant change in the depiction of the figure over the course of the 20th century.